Now, that kind of wood, that kind of wood burns very well because it's so filled with sap. It's impregnated with sap. So, basically sap wood, right? Kind of like fat wood. The sun heats it up and it basically squeezes out the sap. So if you're in a survival situation, need to get a fire going, you find some of this stuff, use that. It's going to burn very well and hot. See that? That's a type of robber fly. See its abdomen undulating or pulsating? That's how they breathe, through their spiracles. They're contracting and expanding it, and that causes air to move in and out of the spiracles. These guys will actually attack other flies and insects in mid-flight. They'll just grab them right out of the air. There's a velvet ant. Amazing creature. These are also called cow killers. They believe that their sting is so painful it'll kill a cow. I don't think that's true. However, sometimes cows would be feeding on grass and one of these would go up their nose, get trapped, and wind up stinging the cow. This is not an ant. It's a flightless wasp. See how it's got that semi-iridescent hairs on it. Very beautiful creature. Very beautiful wasp. So, as you can see, it's pretty easy to get lost out here. You have to constantly look behind yourself. And what I do is anytime I make a turn, I draw an arrow, even a curved line in the ground, you know? And the arrow always points back to where my tent is. Really easy to get lost out here. Check it out. So I gotta do a bit more exploring, and I have to keep looking back to make sure I know where my trail is. Oh, I found a box turtle shell. Spine's still in there, vertebrae. The hinges are still intact, little bush cricket. Awesome, there's one of the legs over there. And I think I just found a skull, I did. Awesome. So, the reason I love the pines so much is because look at them. But, you know, it's such a different world from where I live. And on top of that, the smell is amazing. It smells a little bit spicy and a bit like wintergreen and, of course, like pine, like amber pine. Just smells amazing. So whenever I get back here, as soon as I smell that, I just feel so good. It's a delicious smell. You gotta check it out. Then again, when you hit the cedar swamps, you got that beautiful cedar smell too. It smells like English tea. Just a delicate English tea. So good. That's what causes the red water. So it's got medicinal properties too because of all the tannic acids. So if you have any sores or rashes, helps clear that up. If you're real lucky, you'll find some sphagnum moss in there that you can use too. Check that out. Very hard to film. That's British soldier lichen. Okay. They also call it red coat or soldier moss or red coat moss, but it's British soldier lichen. Really cool things. They're pretty small. See how small that is?
really vibrant.
Look at this little island of stuff. That's so cool. I'll never get over it. I love nature. Never ceases to amaze me.
Hey guys, so I'm gonna show how to make a simple pair of tongs while camping. And first thing I wanna do is make some cordage. So I got some dried grasses and stuff. And what I'm doing is I'm rolling them together. All I'm doing is reverse wrap here, okay? So for me, the right-hand side, right, I'm twisting it away from me. Then I take them both and I cross them over. Okay, so I hold it this way. The right side, you twist away. You press your fibers together, twist them away. And then cross them both towards you. Okay, away, and then towards. So, away, towards. Away, twist them all together, and then twist it towards you. So, the top one, or the right side, if you're holding it this way, goes away from you, and then you cross them both towards you. Twist the right one away from you, then you cross them both towards you. Okay? And you get pretty fast with it. Okay? Now this is pretty much how you do cordage. And you want both sides to be about equal thickness. Because if one side's thinner than the other, it'll wrap around the thicker one. The thicker one will be pretty much straight. They won't twist across each other like this. So its strength and integrity will be compromised.
Put your fibers together when you run out. When you're running close to the end, you just pick another one up and stick it on whatever side's running out and weave it in. Okay? You don't need to tie it or anything like that. You can see I spliced the one in here. I'll just trim that end when I'm done, when I'm ready to go. So now I have a piece of blueberry trunk or branch that I'm going to use. But I got to take the bark off first because the bark gathers bacteria and I want it to dry the appropriate way. So I'm going to remove all the bark. Maybe I'll leave some at the end, one of the ends for the handle just to make it look cool. So I'm peeling the bark off now and you can tell it's still wet underneath. That's not good. It's going to dry and split or twist or warp, but it'll suffice for tonight. So I don't know if you guys have ever smelled this blueberry wood, but it smells beautiful. And so does the wild grape that I harvested the other day. They both smell really good. So now I'm gonna wrap it around here so it doesn't split. That'll keep the split from occurring. But this piece of wood's way too green, so this probably isn't gonna work. But I'm gonna wrap it anyways. Now I'm going to tap the blade down, and it's going to split the whole way, I can tell. Now I'm going to wedge a stick in there, to keep it open, and then wrap it shut. Okay, so I've got a crude pair of tongs now, see? And they work pretty good. You know, this is for picking up coals and placing them more accurately and stuff like that, and I can use it for burning out a wooden bowl. So there's the cordage I put on it to check it, keep it from splitting all the way down. I put a little stick in there to keep it pried open, and I could wedge another one in there. All I have to do now is carve down the tips here so that they're nice and flat and not thick like that. Still smells good. Check out that crazy caterpillar. It's not the first time I found one of these.
Check out this leech, guys. That's a big ol' leech. That's like out of Stand By Me. It's huge. It's my first time ever seeing a big one. Wow. That's crazy. It's actually the first time I saw a big leech. Let me tell you, this one's big.
That's a spring. That's why the water here is 55 degrees. There's another one right there.
Definitely a stealth predator there, an ambush predator.
And honey.
Yeah, check out the sheen on these guys. Nice reflective hairs.
Aren't those scales awesome? Too bad I'm so shaky.
Looks like my friends left, and I had so much trouble sleeping last night, the mosquitoes kept buzzing around my ear. They weren't biting me, but they wouldn't stop, and I didn't even try to go to bed until like 3 or 4, but once I tried, it was pretty hard to get to sleep. I kept waking up or couldn't fall asleep, and I get up today, and I heard my friends packing up, but by the time I actually got up, they were just leaving. I saw them walking out. And they didn't want their dogs to wake me up or anything like that. And I was a little sad. And then I found a note from them on my one of the logs I have here with their email and stuff. So that's pretty cool. So guys, you know who you are. Thanks a lot. I had a good time meeting you and talking with you. And I'm pretty happy you left me your email.
By the way, check out these pitcher plants. Another plant native to the Pine Barrens. Characteristic of the Pine Barrens habitat. Okay. As you probably know, this is a carnivorous plant. It's got these giant cups that collect rainwater. And tiny little hairs that point downwards into the plant. That are very slippery. So if a creature, if a little ant lands in there or something, can't really climb out. Those hairs hold it in. And as I said, they only point in one direction, into the mouth of the plant. so they drown in the fluids that are often replenished with rainwater and digestive juices. And then the plant absorbs the vitamins and minerals from the digested ant or insect. So it's a really neat plant.
So the reason why these plants are carnivorous is because the soil is very poor in nutrients. Okay? It's the pine barrens. And they grow next to the water and stuff in the sand. So to acquire those extra nutrients, they have evolved to become carnivorous and to feed off the insects and stuff like that. There's also sundews and a whole bunch of different sundew plants too, which I'll show you what they look like. One of my favorite, all-time favorite plants.
Okay guys, sorry about the lighting, but I really want you to see this plant here. This is the sundew, okay? Another carnivorous plant, which is really awesome because it has these little bits of like honeydew, sticky stuff, and the ends of these tiny little projections. And what happens is an insect walks along, bumps it, or lands on it, and then the plant slowly engulfs it. Okay? The insect can't get away because they're so sticky. Those are like little globs of glue. And then again, the plant starts to digest the insect because of the low nutrition in the soil. One of my favorite plants of all time. Let me show you some close-up footage of it, okay? And there you go, those are the little flowers for the sundew. Really neat plant. So this is when the plant blooms. This is when sundews in bloom. Really love this stuff. Now that's a cool little mushroom. Look at this guy. That's awesome. Look how small it is. That's my finger.
This forest has been burned not too long ago. There was a fire through here. That's why I see all these black pitch pines and all this beautiful grass. But in a few years' time, it'll be replaced by pitch pine, of course, scrub oak, blackjack oak, some greenbrier, tons and tons of blueberry and dewberry and huckberry and all those. So the pine barrens need fires to keep them pine barrens.
That is from a spider, a wolf spider probably. Now check out how big around that is. It's a little bit wider than my finger.
Okay. Now this here is an antline underneath that cone. In the middle is an antline. It's just like that thing out of Return of the Jedi. There's the jaws. That's a creepy creature. I'm going to try to show you what this creature looks like out of the ground. Now that's an antlion. Okay? Not the biggest creature on Earth. Big jaws, but they don't hurt people. And this is the larval form. This is the child. They'll come out later on in the year. And they get these big wings. They look sort of like a cross between a damselfly and a dragonfly. And they fly kind of clumsy. They still have kind of big jaws, but they don't use them. They're mostly for mating and stuff. So pretty cool, huh? Crazy looking creature. Now watch how he buries himself. He'll go backwards to bury himself. And I'll put him in some loose sand to see what happens. See, he just goes right backwards into the ground. Pretty neat, huh?
Female. Look how big the antlion is. This is awesome. Bill, you would love this. These guys are going to excavate. They'll excavate a hole. I don't know if the egg's already in there or they'll put the egg in that sphere of fecal matter afterwards. But, and then the baby will develop and, you know, go around inside it. I guess feed on the inside and also be protected. There's not a lot of things to eat. Scat. These mosquitoes are kicking my butt. That is so cool. Man, I wish I had my other camera. So I found some kind of boring insect. Probably a pine. Sawyer.
There's one of the deer flies. These guys are voracious, man. They're relentless. They just bite and it burns and itches. These guys don't leave me alone.
But their eyes are awesome if you get a chance to see it. This is a pleasant surprise. Look how crystal clear this water is. It makes me so thirsty. And this is why I go camping out in the pines. For things like this. Beautiful. Look how clear that water is.
So that's what I mean about the Pine Barrens just being amazing. Check out how filtered this water is. Look at that. That's several feet deep. Okay? Almost 3 feet deep, and it's crystal clear. You just can't see because of the sun, but it's gorgeous. Well, check out this awesome swamp I just found. It's pretty cool. There's sphagnum moss all over the place, and cranberries, cedars, dead cedars, birds, you know, all sorts of singing insects and stuff. Really cool stuff. And some carpenter frogs. So, this marks the conclusion of my Lower Forge camp trip video for summer of 2015. I'll probably be back here before next year, but that's the video. So I really hope you guys enjoyed it. And also, you know, this was just a taste of the things that live here. The Pine Barrens is an amazing habitat. It's very unique. There's a lot of specialists that live here that you can't find anywhere else. Also, as I said before, Warden State Forest is the biggest Pine Barrens in the world, okay? So, feel free to hit like and subscribe for more videos. I'd really appreciate it. You know, it helps me to make more videos and it gets my name out there. And I'm Chris Egnoto. Hope you enjoyed my YouTube video. Signing out.